He picked his way forward. Can he spin? Yes, he can. Can he go to the end zone, hit it for the corner? Touchdown, Valdosta.
Blazers!
The Hal Mumme Show, a weekly look at Valdosta State Blazer football, is brought to you by Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right. By Winn-Dixie, America's supermarket. By Wendy's, the best hamburger and a whole lot more. By Nations Bank, the power to make a difference. By Swanee Swifty, designed with your convenience in mind. By the Georgia Lottery Corporation, the most fun a dollar can buy. By the Florida Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Coca-Cola Classic, always a good call, always Coca-Cola. And by Budweiser, fresh, pure, natural, proud to be your bud.
He didn't want North Alabama just to grind it out on the ground and take all the time off the clock. Hatch with a deep drop. And down the field, he's got Greer at 23, 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Steve Greer for the Blazers. Touchdown, Valdosta State University.
Hello again and welcome to the show. I'm John Lastinger along with the head coach of the Valdosta State University Blazers, Hal Mumme. Saturday night in Cleveland Field, the nation's number one ranked team in Division II, the University of North Alabama Lions come to town to face the Blazers, and like two heavyweight fighters going at it toe-to-toe, back and forth all night long, a tremendous ball game, but in the end, the number one ranked Lions proved to be a little too much as they win it by a score of 31-21. Coach, you're never happy about losing a football game, but this was certainly a great one.
Oh, it was. It was well worth the price of a ticket, and we had a lot of people bought those and came out to watch us play.
In fact, we had over 9,000, fourth largest crowd in Valdosta State University history, a great ball game. A little too much offense. Tyrone Rush of North Alabama is certainly a great player.
He is. I think they're great players, made plays when they had to, although I think our defense did a great job. We held them well under, about 150 yards under their rushing average, and I thought we did a great job containing them. I felt like we played well enough defensively to win the game.
Stay with us, and we'll see that when we come back with the first half highlights.
The finest U.S. choice beef. Aged for tenderness. And now the 1/8 inch trim, because we know you like it lean. That's WD brand U.S. choice beef. From Winn-Dixie, the beef people.
It's where the careers of naval officers are launched and where pleasure boaters come to cast away from it all. But Annapolis, Maryland is also a major financial center because it's served by Nations Bank, which enables coastal properties to call on a depth of experience in financing, offers the overstreets everything from equity loans to mutual funds, and gives people a bank that puts greater financial power at their command. In Annapolis and in 1,900 other communities throughout our nation.
If you do one thing, do it right in the middle of the day. Don't even try it if you can't come through. You say you want chicken? Well, that's what we do. We do chicken right. We are KFC. We do chicken right. Oh, that's what we do. We do chicken right. We are KFC. We do chicken right.
Welcome back to the Hal Mumme Show, Coach. Big football games often come down to who makes the least amount of mistakes. And this time the Blazers, you played well offensively, but you did have some costly turnovers.
Yeah, we did, John, and you're right. I mean, we talked about this last week that, you know, whoever executed their offense the best and turned the ball over the least, didn't make mistakes in the kicking game, had a chance, probably the best chance to win. And unfortunately, our offense, we turned it over six times, had five interceptions and a fumble, and kind of a backhanded compliment to us on that, and that is that we could do that against the number one team in the nation, still have a chance to win the game with 3 minutes left to go. So it's a positive, and then it shows that we're a very strong team, but it's a negative in that it cost us the football game.
Let's take a look at the first half highlight. Coach, last home game for some of your senior players.
Yeah, it sure was. Chuck Stamey, Sean Bostic, Blake Duncan, Calvin Walker, Reggie West, Mark Beach, and York Korinsky all finished up.
There you see the Blazers coming onto the field, and the old foghorn there sounding, the siren. It was a very excited crowd at this point.
It was. We brought it all out for them. Black uniforms, smoke, fire, everything. We took everything we had to stay in this one. With a fine team like North Alabama.
So we opened the game. Blazers win the toss and elect to receive, and they right away don't kick it to you and go with the pooch kick.
Still getting by on our legacy of the Texas return right there. We start out with a good game with Dominique Ross running over blocked by Blake Duncan, York Prince, and Matt Moore. And then Blake here with a great catch and run afterwards. Breaks several tackles and picks up first down.
He has perfected the swing pass, hasn't he?
He has. And there, this is Sean Pender from Jacksonville making the catch. And Sean's mom and daddy were there to see the game, as was his uncle. There's Dominique Ross again getting a good run. They elected to go with a nickel defense to open the game, and so we took advantage of it here with Dominique a couple of times.
Ross had a great game, 22 carries, 112 yards. He needs only 50 more to reach 1,000 for the season.
Well, we're sure hoping he'll get that. This is young Billy Poole. He's a freshman from Lowndes and running the sweep and getting us down here close to the goal line. Got a great block there from Timmy Fleming and Matt Moore out there pulling in front. And then we're going to come back here with a little play we put in. Got a true freshman here from Valdosta High School. Chris Rocky catches his first touchdown pass.
Right.
And a little celebrating going on. That's as good a drive as we've had against a great team since I've been here. That's
72, 10-play, 72-yard drive.
I'm very, very pleased with that. And we've done that 8 out of 9 games we've played in, so we're real proud of that, too. We'll get an extra point out of Vernon Laurie and Mark Beach holding and Alex Arias snapping.
But hold on to your seat, because here come the Lions right back.
Well, they're not number one in the nation for no reason, and they do a great job with this drive. They're Satterfield, they're great fullback, and we limited him to 59 yards on the night, and that's really a credit to our defensive front. They did a great job. And this Satterfield catching pass out of the backfield, that's a little wrinkle we hadn't seen.
One of three passes they attempted on the night.
Mike Gibson made the play there, and then here's Satterfield with a very determined run, and you can see why that young man's probably going to be in somebody's NFL camp next year.
Yeah, Tyrone Rush, a great night. He had over 100 yards rushing. And then Cody Gross on a little lead option there will take it 25 yards for a touchdown.
Well, that's a great play by them. Of course, they respond to our great drive, and so it's all tied up again 7-7.
Jamie Stoddard with the extra point, and they were knotted at 7.
It's two great football teams playing each other, and you kind of expect that early.
From this point on, I thought your defense really tightened it down and played well, Coach.
They did. They played the fullback better. We defensed the option. They really didn't hurt us with the option anymore, and that was
here's a great play coming up here.
Got a good play by Mike Berry and Tony Hill right there, and we pretty much took that quarterback keeper away the rest of the night.
First quarter ends. We're tied at 7.
Got a great stop here on Tyrone Rush by Rasmus Harvey and Andre Hampton. Our whole front there, Ed Mitchell's in on the play. We're back in here, and this is our first possession, second quarter. And we got Robert Williams catching a screen pass here. And then we come back with a little swing pass to Blake Duncan again. He makes a number 4 miss right there. Old Blake was working that corner over there all night. He and number 4 got real friendly before the night was over.
The senior from Warner Robins, he did have a big night.
Now we got a little bootleg play here off the fake to Dominique. Greer makes a good catch, gets us about 5 yards. This was, our scoring did come off 3 great drives, and that was a real positive for our offense right there. Here's Hatch. Find Steve Greer here on one of the better plays we've made this year, and Steve breaks the tackle, and the guy tried to strip the ball on him there and went for the strip instead of tackling. Steve broke it and got it in the end zone.
Great job by Greer catching the touchdown pass, 43 yards from Chris Hatcher. Hatcher's second touchdown pass of the night. Vernon Laurie with the point after, and you're back in front 14-7.
Our young men competed hard all night. They played every snap as hard as they could. Here's a good look at Shea Williams and Tony Hill getting in there, Marcus Johnson, Andre Randall. The thing we talked to our defense about was they were going to have to swarm to the ball, and I think they really rose to the occasion and did that. And like I said before, our defense and special teams really played well enough for us to win. Our offense played that well in spots. We just, like we said earlier, the turnovers kind of got us. But here's Andre Hampton getting a sack on him. That was a key third down play right there.
Especially when you didn't think Andre Hampton might, was questionable before the ball game.
Yeah, Andre was in the hospital 30 minutes before the game. He had 104 temperature. I tell you, Billy Hyde is the defense coordinator at North Alabama. He deserves most credit for that interception right there because they showed us the disguise coverage we hadn't seen before.
Their linebackers were very active in the ball game.
They did a great job, and particularly their middle backer in coverage. Here's Rush with a very determined run. Again, you can see that guy's even making yards when he's on the ground already. Got a sweep carry here. This is a fumble we thought we had right here, but the officials ruled that the whistle had blown. So our defense did rise up and stop them, so they end up getting a field goal out of this.
You keep them out. When you consider that inside the 20-yard line, I think they had they've been inside the 20 42 times and have come away with 35 touchdowns. So it's rare that you do it.
Very proficient. Great offense.
Halftime ends. Blazers lead at 14-10. Stay with us. We'll look at the second half highlights. Thanks for joining us on the Hal Mumme Show. As we said, Blazers led it 14-10 at halftime. Coach, what discussions took place in the locker room at half?
Well, we made some adjustments offensively, made a few defensively. The defense had already started playing pretty well and hold them, so they pretty much decided to stay what they were doing. Offensively, we went back to what we were doing in the first quarter, which had worked better than what we did in the second quarter. So that's what we talked about mainly. I don't think anybody thought the game was won or anything like that. Our guys have been against North Alabama before, and so as far as motivation stuff, we just told them to go out and play hard again and try and maintain what they were doing.
Let's take a look at the second half highlights. Yeah, I guess it's not one you certainly didn't have to tell them to get a little more emotional because they were a charged bunch in the first half.
Yeah, I'll tell you, there couldn't have been much more electricity on the sideline. We'd all got fried. There's a great play right there by Shea Williams and Rasmus Harvey and Michael Gibson on the tackle.
North Alabama takes the second half kickoff, and your defense plays well in the first series.
They do, but I tell you, this play right here, that's the second year in a row Tyrone Rush has jumped over Marcus Johnson. This year, at least Marcus forced him to the sideline where he came down out of bounds. But we had him pretty well stopped, but they're great split end. Shelton right here runs reverse, and they get a great block right there, and we miss the tackle. And then pretty soon we look up and they're down here knocking on our door.
In center field, well, he'll take it down to the one, and Cody Gross, their sophomore quarterback, will take it in from 1 yard out. And as we talked about, we're back and forth, and now North Alabama goes up 17-14.
Back up with a lead, and we're going to try and work it down here. I think we get a little drive started with a throw there to Calvin Walker.
Calvin had 5 catches. He now has 76 on the season.
Well, Calvin's having a great senior year, and we'd like him to finish up strong this week. There's a good little play to Steve Greer, same little play ran in the first half. And that guy right there is kind of confused, but the players are doing all right. So we're 4th down right here. We make it with Dominique Ross over York Kerensky and Matt Moore. Matt Moore and York Kerensky be commended. They did a great job over there run blocking all night. We found the left side going pretty good.
So much is said about North Alabama's offense, but their defense is great, too.
Oh, they are. They got some great people inside. And I'll tell you, they did a great job. They sacked Hatcher 3 times. That's more than we've been sacked in a long time. There's the touchdown pass to Calvin Walker. I thought Chris did a great job in the pocket and escaping and finding Calvin. That was great play right there. And of course, Calvin's been a great player for us for 2 years now. He makes the big plays in the big games.
That was a 15-play, 84-yard drive. Calvin Walker, 10 yards from Chris Hatcher. You're back in front, 21-17.
Yeah, and then, of course, like the great team they are, here they come back with Rush and Satterfield. And, you know, we've got people on them right there. They're doing a great job running over us. And, you know, at times they just got real determined. It was hard to slow them down, no matter how many people you had on them. But we were managing to get a hat on a hat all the time, so that was...
We start the 4th quarter. Again, Tyrone Rush hammering in there for a couple of yards.
This was a key 4th down play right here, and we kind of thought we had him stopped. And it's really hard to tell. We couldn't tell on film. And of course, after they measured it out, it came up just by inches. And then, of course, they go on and rush. What a great run right there for the touchdown. You know, it's a game of inches, and we wish those inches had gone our way right there, but they didn't.
So North Alabama answers with a 10-play, 69-yard run. The great touchdown by Tyrone Rush. But here comes your offense working it right back down the field.
Our guys, you know, they never gave up. And they thought they were going to win this game right down to the end of it. It's a credit to their spirit that they were hanging there against a great team like North Alabama. You're going to see some great 4th down plays.
Here's the first one here. You faked the punt, and there goes Billy Poole around the right end.
Well, our little freshman from Lowndes High did a great job right there. Got the handoff from Keith Braddock, and they executed that. Coach Gary Griffin put that in just for North Alabama last week. Did a great job and was very handy at that moment. And we're going to get a good throw here from Hatcher over to Calvin Walker. This is a key drive. The clock's winding down, and we've got to make some plays. Robert Williams going to make 2 great ones right here, the first one.
People wonder why 4th down you kept going for it, but you just couldn't afford to give them the ball back because with that ground game, they you may never see it again.
That's right. That had happened to us the year before, and we weren't going to let that happen. We went into this game figuring that we had to fire all the bullets, and we certainly weren't going to leave them.
Tremendous play there. Chris Hatcher on 4th and 10 to Robert Williams, who catches it and stretches to get the first down.
Great awareness by Robert, knowing where that stake is. And he gets it right there, and we get another throw, another completion here to Sean Penner, and then we're going to have an incompletion that's not on the film to Stanley Flanders. We just missed having a touchdown pass just by inches. And we end up turning it over on downs right here, and our defense is asked to rise to the occasion, and they do.
Certainly do.
That's another reason that went into our thinking. Every time we went for it on 4th down, we looked down at Coach Major, and he always said, go for it. And so I think it's a great compliment to our coaching staff and our players that they have that much confidence in each other.
There you stop Tyrone Rush, you get the ball back, force them to punt it, and right away you hit Calvin Walker, and I think this is a costly play here.
Yeah, this is the interception. Hatcher got his arm hit just as he released it a little bit, and their great middle linebacker runs it in, gets the touchdown, and really seals our fate right there at that point. Puts us away, but you know, we managed to stay in it that long. With 6 turnovers, like I say, you know, if we could cure the turnover bug, we'd sure like to do it again.
Well, you see the clock winding down. You're under a minute and a half, and still you're coming right back down trying to get a quick touchdown.
Well, we knew this play right here is going to be another interception. Hatch had to throw this up because we had to leave a minute on the clock right here. Really, that's one of those intricate things right there that people don't notice. That interception is really not Hatcher's fault right there. He just had a receiver do the wrong thing.
So it ends up 24-21. Let's take a look. As you see, congratulating Bobby Wallace. Let's look at the statistics. You win the first down battle, 22-18, passing yards, 238. Certainly a respectable night, but not what you have in the past. And you get 132 yards rushing, but I guess the costly thing is the turnovers.
Well, we'd like to have the long pass to Stanley. If we could have one back, that'd put us over 300.
As we tell you, North Alabama wins it 31-21. Stay with us, and we'll take a look around the Gulf South Conference.
Guard dog. Oh, very scary. Wow. Finally, the good stuff.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Tired of waiting in long checkout lines when you have just a few items and you're in a rush? Come to Swanee Swifty instead. It's fast, easy, and there's one just around the corner. Plus, you'll find practically everything under the sun. Stop in and gas up or pick up groceries or a snack to go. The Swanee Swifty store. They're on your way, so you can be on your way. Stop by today and save.
At your Swanee Swifty.
Out of the literally millions and millions of numbers out there, 46 of them are headed this way. So if you want to play Lotto Georgia from the Georgia Lottery, pick six out of the blue. Then every Saturday night around 11, watch to see if your numbers come in.
What's this?
We're here for your birthday party!
That's next week.
Oh, Ed.
Does that mean there's no food?
There's a Wendy's nearby.
Now you're talking!
Everything on Wendy's Super Value Menu is 99 cents each. Freshly made salads, hamburgers hot off the grill, chili, delicious food you can only get here. Plus, for $1.99, get a hamburger kids meal.
Happy birthday! Look, we're twins!
Great.
Wendy's, you don't pay more, you just get more.
Welcome back to the Hal Mumme Show. Coach, it's no secret all eyes were on Valdosta, Georgia for the matchup of the two top-ranked teams in the Gulf South Conference. But contrary to belief, there were some other games played in the conference
sure
this weekend.
Let's take a look at them, John.
I guess a game of interest considering that our next opponent is Henderson State. But
well,
big numbers.
They had a real shootout with Livingston right there, and Henderson State came out on top.
Livingston is known for that. West Georgia, they just keep coming. They have climbed into a second-place tie with the Blazers in the conference. They beat Delta 27-7.
They've really come on of late.
And in Central Arkansas, loses to Mississippi College. The Choctaws win that one by a score of 21-14. Let's take a look at the standings. As we see, North Alabama is still perfect. They're 6-0 in the conference, 9-0 overall. The Blazers 4-2, 7-3 overall. And as we tell you, West Georgia moves into a tie with the Blazers. They have to play at North Alabama next week.
Correct.
And in a couple of other games, Mississippi College is at Delta State, and University of Central Arkansas, I think, is at Portland State. So,
go to Portland State. It'd be an interesting game right
should
there.
Be another exciting and an interesting weekend of Gulf South Conference football. Stay with us for some closing comments. Coach, it's hard to believe we're coming up on the 11th game of the season, but next week I got to go to Arkadelphia, Arkansas to face Henderson State.
Well, the Reddies won a big game against Livingston this week, John. They've got a good football team, particularly a good defensive football team, so it'll be a real challenge.
The playoff picture. Obviously, you know, we need a win against Henderson State, but I think your players will be motivated in that regard.
Yeah, our players are going to be up for this one. It's our last game for seven seniors, and they want to go out on a winning note, and they don't like losing. And I'm sure that the playoff picture is in the back of their mind, but you know, that's really out of our control at this point. They have to pick the four best teams from the South, and we played North Alabama pretty good. We hope they think we're one of them.
All right, Coach, as we do every week, let me hear the song of the week.
The Buffett song of the week this week is dedicated to my daughter, Karen. It's great to have daughters when you lose a game. They make you feel better. But anyway, this one's door number three. I kind of feel like the old boy in this song.
Well, I can't wait to hear it. I always like to hear those Jimmy Buffett songs. That'll wrap up another edition of the Hal Mumme Show. Thanks for joining us. Join us next week as Valdosta State University takes on Henderson State. We'll see you then.
Until I